there. The response to Stipe Drews. Respectful. They're here to see one man, Danny Green. 6'5". 34 years of age. The current WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. This is title defense number one. To enemy territory. Danny Green, Stipe Drews, center ring. This is the biggest stage of them all. It is world title time. Main event TV. Fox Sports, pubs and clubs, getting you as close to the action as you can. Let's go to Matt Campbell.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fox Sports, Main Event Boxing, NRW Holdings Limited, and Mean Green Promotions are proud to bring you tonight's main event. 12 3-minute rounds to decide the WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. Introducing out of the blue corner, wearing his famous green trunks, weighing 79.2 kilos, with a professional record of 27 fights for 24 wins, 22 by way of knockout. Trained by Ismail Salash from right here in Perth, Danny the Green Machine Green. His opponent fighting out in the red corner, wearing the red shorts and weighing in identical weight at 79.2 kilos. He has fought 33 times. He has been defeated once in his last visit to our shores. He has had 13 of his 32 wins by way of knockout. He's trained by Valentin Silagi. He trains in Germany, but he hails from Croatia. He is the WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. Stipe the Spider-Man Drews. Your judges for this title fight: Tom Miller from the USA, Jean-Louis Leblanc from France, Levi Martinez from the USA, and your referee, Mr. Takeshi Shimakawa from Japan. Let's get it on!
Takeshi Shinyama, our referee. Here we go. Sit back. Try and relax.
The atmosphere is incredible.
Danny Green. Is he on the verge of history? twice he has travelled for the WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Twice denied. Is it a case of third time lucky? WBA light heavyweight title. 36 minutes of work if we go to the judges' scorecard. Drews in the red, Danny in the green. 6 foot five is Stipe Drews. Danny Green just a tick over 6 foot. A massive 14 centimeter reach advantage in favor of the champion, in favor of the Croatian.
And as he came to the ring, he did step over the top rope, which is what I expected from him. But Danny putting the pressure on in the opening minute here. Drews on the back foot already.
And this is Stipe Drews' style. He'll just stay on the back foot. He'll circle left or right. Just trying to, he wants Danny Green to commit, and then he's going to counter him.
He's got his left hand cocked. For our viewers out there, this, as from a southpaw stance, means you stand with your left-handed generally, you stand with your right foot forward, and your power comes from your left hand. He just tried the straight left there, and it was deflected by Danny's glove. Danny looking to land a good shot. Good stiff jab by Danny Green.
This is the first title defence for Stipe Drews. He beat the vulnerable Silvio Branco for this title in April of this year.
You've got to give Drews credit for coming down here to Perth to fight Danny Green in front of his home crowd.
For sure. I mean, you know, he's a proud champion. He's here to put his title on the line and hope to go home with the belt. He's boxing well in the opening round. Danny's landed the cleaner shots at the minute. Drews, I don't think, has really landed with the solid blow yet. Drews on the back foot. Danny, I would like to see him, and I'm sure we'll see it happen as the fight unfolds, but go to the midsection of Drews with the right drive. It's a far more accessible target than the head.
1 minute remaining, round number one.
Jab to the body from Green.
Danny's still trying to just figure out this range and the difference in distance.
That was a nice left hand there from Danny Green.
Yeah, the stiffer shots have come from Green this round. Oh, there's right a good hand. Right hand.
Green tied balance. Up in the ropes.
His leg slipped out of the ring. Let's hope he's done no damage there, but the cleaner shot so far this round, Danny Green.
Drews had a stunned look on his face then when he took that punch.
30 seconds remain, round number one. Green on the front foot again. It is Drews almost inviting Green to come into his personal space, looking for Danny Green to walk into the big left hand.
Good jab.
Drews 13 knockouts in 32 professional victories.
Oh, what a lovely left hook from Danny Green.
Late in round number one.
Danny Green, the aggressor in the third round. A good round for Danny Green.
An excellent round for the challenger.
Seven down, round.
A feeling of confidence from the blue corner. Very composed, Ismail Salas. No yelling from Angelo Haider. Danny sat there and absorbed the instructions.
You know, a good opening round for Danny Green. He definitely landed the cleaner shots that round.
Our three ringside judges, Tom Miller from the United States, Levi Martinez from the United States, and Jean-Louis Leclan from France.
Drews using the ring, trying to draw Danny in. Danny needs, I'd like to see Danny throw that right drive to the body as he's chasing him off. Drews comes back with a good left hand there.
And that'll be Drew's tactics. Make Danny Green miss and counter with that left.
Drews has yet to taste the power of the green machine at light heavyweight.
And he's got Danny Green's got to cut him off as he's moving the ring. He's got to step the opposite direction. Right drive to body is the one I want to see him use.
A straight to the chest. It's about perfect height for Danny with an extended right hand. Drew's cautious, respectful.
Good right hand from Green. Danny made those shots miss well there.
It was only short from Green. It worked. Middle stages of round number two.
There's the right drive to body, glancing blow. Needs to get right up on it. Drew started this round better, but Green has fought his way back into the round. Drews just feeling with that right jab.
Drews, an Olympian in Atlanta, Green, an Olympian in Sydney, 4 years later.
Drews is not giving up enough defense to win this round at the moment.
Good Green right hand, good shots from Danny Green. Good right and left.
There's a good short little right hand there on the inside from Danny Green.
Stipe will do whatever he has to secure a victory here.
Oh, another right hand from Green.
Oh,
and again.
Green tags Drews.
Brought a smile to Drews' face. A sure sign that he was hurt by it, but good shots from Danny Green. Good left hand from Drews there. Good countering punch. 50 seconds to go. Round two.
Green on the front.
Oh, there's the one.
Drews.
That's the shot against the southpaw, the right hand.
Danny Green on the front foot, looking to finish it early. It will take more than that to walk away with the championship goal.
Good
inside
shots.
Inside the final 30 seconds.
Good jab to the body. A good Green round.
Showing composure too, Danny. Relying on that left hand, relying on the jab. Question for talking, and Drews!
Doesn't like the rough stuff, so Drews, he's got Danny Green in a headlock. Another clear round to Danny Green.
A good round to Danny Green. But no good on the Croatian, so I can't tell you what the instructions were, but Stipe Drews, Barry, was collected in round two. Not once, but twice.
He was certainly collected with some very good shots, and he whinged about the rough stuff. He didn't like the rough stuff up close. This is professional boxing.
And the important thing, the referee broke them quickly. Yeah. He's very authoritative with Stipe Drews. He's not going to allow him to any extra holding.
Here we go, round number three. Now Stipe Drews has tasted the power of Danny Green.
Andy, we've seen this before.
Okay. Okay.
This is going to end up an absolute war.
I think so.
Green marches forward.
Hey, Green, okay?
Stipe Drews has felt Green's power, and he doesn't like it.
Green keeping centre ring two and for himself. Just a little eager there, overstepping, whilst trying to lunge with the left hand. Drews now very cautious, almost not throwing punches.
Yeah, Drews appeared to be tending to throw then.
He's felt the power of Danny Green and he doesn't like it.
Old-fashioned headlock from Stipe Drews. If he wants to fight, Danny Green will fight. Make no mistake about that.
That's for sure. Keep him straight, Danny. Straight shots. As Ricky Hatton quite often says, it's not a tickling contest up there.
One of the great quotes of 2007.
Stipe Drews trying to use his reach here.
14-centimetre reach advantage to the Croatian. And a very wide stance up here.
He's not throwing, though. He's making all these gestures, but he's not throwing. You don't win rounds by not throwing punches.
Inside
Danny Green's making the fight.
Nice right hand from Green. Drews does very well to turn him.
Danny Green off balance, but he's made this, he's made all the fight this round.
Stipe Drews has been hurt by Danny Green's power shots and he doesn't want to be anywhere near them.
What about the intensity and urgency of Danny Green twice losing his balance in the process?
Oh, there's the right hand.
Good shot from Green.
And Green's not rushing, he's,
good
he's
left
been
hand.
Purposeful of his punches.
Good left hand from Green too.
Okay.
15 seconds remaining, it's another Danny Green round for Mike. My scorecard, he's got away with these first three. Drews just not doing enough.
Drews with that left hand pop.
Stop.
Bell sounds, end of the round. They stand down after 9 minutes. have a look at some of the action, Barry, from round number three.
Rough house tactics there. Very awkward Stipe Drews, but Danny's making the fight and landing the cleaner shots.
We have got a war on our hands. Danny will fight you. Danny will box you. He'll accommodate. I'd be very interested to find out exactly what Stipe Drews was weighing as he stands, because even to the naked eye, he looks appreciably bigger around the chest and abdomen than what he did at the weigh-in yesterday, where he looked gaunt.
He's a big man. He really is. For a light heavyweight, he's a big man.
Barry Michael, unofficially, 30-27 in favour of Danny Green. Our three ringside judges, Tommy Miller, Levi Martinez, and Jean-Louis Legrand.
Drew's trying different things this round.
Danny looking to load up, and he finds the target zone with the left hand.
Okay. Hey, bye.
Stalking. Nice jab to the midsection.
Drew's moving well, but not landing much.
Drew's on his bike, but how's he going to win this round if he's not landing punches?
Exactly, Paul. He's just not landing shots.
Does it appear to you, Barry, that the game plan for the Croatian is, let's weather the early storm. This guy will knock you out.
Yep.
We're going to get him from 6 to 12.
I would say that's probably their game plan. They expect Danny to expend a lot of energy, but Drew, you've got to remember, Drew's is moving a lot too. He's expending energy. Not doing a lot, but using the rings. Danny finding him hard to tag cleanly, but still doing enough to win the round.
Pulled for a very tall man.
Now, that was good by Drews.
That was clearly in the back of the head.
That was clearly in the back of the head, but it was a good counter prior to that. Oh.
A sorry from Stipe Drews there. I don't know how much weight that carries. Hand. That's a better punch. That's a scoring punch from Danny Green.
Stiff left jab. I felt that out here.
Worked so intensely on his endurance in the lead up to his date with destiny, many have said. Drews, for a big man, his lateral movement is cat-like. Very,
very good. He moves very well. He's a hard target to pin.
He is trying to frustrate Danny Green and also to tire him out. As you said, Andy, he wants to weather the early storm from the green machine.
Yeah.
But I think this green machine is stronger than the one we've seen before in other world title fights. I think keep this pace up a lot longer.
Yeah, I think so. He can keep this pace up.
Green! Big shot from Danny Green.
Boxing very well.
Late in round four. Equally as good was the way Drews took it and then turned. Final couple of seconds. Once again, we are preparing to go to the stools. And a trickle of blood from the nose of the champion. There it is.
Blatant blow to the back of the head. It was a good counter prior to that, though, but he probably lost his clean point by that blatant foul. But Danny landed some clean shots here.
Keeping in mind, Danny Green doing it tonight, looking for the world championship. His lovely wife, Nina, sitting ringside, due to give birth to their second child today.
Danny Green very keen to get on with it.
And it's more than a trickle of blood out of the nose of Stipe Drews, who appears cautious at best. Barry Michael has it a shutout, 40-36 in favour of Green.
Oh, that hurt Drews.
Drews holding on.
Cracker of a left hook. Drews was wobbled there. The spray flew off his head.
Grabbed Danny Green in the headlock. Then Green said, if you want to play that game, I'll reciprocate.
Referee breaking them quickly. That's to Danny Green's advantage.
That was the best shot of the fight so far. I think that was a cracking left hook.
There's a lot of blood coming from Stipe Drews' nose now.
They're looking to use the jab. coming from the Croatian corner through a translator. The jab is the key to keeping Danny Green at bay as Drews moves into a right-handed stance.
Back to the southpaw.
Back to left with a smile on his face.
Look, his jab, his right jab has been ineffective so far. He's just feeling with it. He's fainting with it. He's not doing, he's not landing it.
He hasn't got the power to hold Danny Green off.
Stipe Drews with 13 knockouts and 32 wins. Hasn't won in a knockout since March 2005. Otherwise, he has been the distance.
Danny Green fighting a real thinking fight here. A lot of concentration from both boys.
Still not enough offense from Stipe Drews.
The intensity of the contest is as high as you will get.
Yeah, you're right, Paul. You can't win a round when you're not landing punches or throwing punches. There's nothing coming really authoritarian coming from Drews at this stage.
It's Barry, it's not even landing punches. He's just not throwing the punches.
Exactly. Yeah. I think he's scared, not scared to throw them, but tentative. He's been hit with some big shots. That left hook this round was a cracker. Danny loosening up now as he goes down under.
A nice stiff left jab to the midsection, trying to slow down Stipe Drews, trying to get the hands down lower and present a target zone up top. Final 30 seconds, round five. That's nice, Danny Green.
Good counter to the right jab.
Danny's not being over-aggressive. He's sticking to the game plan.
Stop!
15 seconds to go.
Drews is smiling a lot. I don't know what he's smiling about.
Neither do I.
He's going home without some luggage that he came over to Perth with at this stage anyway.
That's for sure.
Still a long way to go.
Whoa. Right on the bell.
Stipe Drews thought about it. Decided against it. Seconds being called out of the ring at the moment. Ooh. That was flush.
That was a beautiful left hand from Danny Green.
Drew's very quick to get up and get out to the middle of the ring. So his mindset is still a positive one.
As champion, he's got to start doing more, though. He hasn't won a round on our scorecard so far.
Let's not forget, Barry, you only have to win 7 rounds of a 12-round fight to get the win.
Yeah, right. Well, he's 5 behind, though. On our unofficial scorecards, of course, but I don't know how you could see it any other way, Paul.
I totally agree.
Oh! Green nails Drews with a beautiful left hand.
Drews hangs on.
And wisely so.
What's he talking? What's he complaining about?
What Drews was trying to say that he should be punching on the when they're holding.
Stop!
Until the referee says break, Danny Green's entitled to punch.
Stipe Drews continues the verbal assault on Danny Green. Danny's not saying a word. He's just putting his right fist on the end of his nose.
He's just doing the business. Vicious body shot in there.
Danny's speaking Croatian in his punches.
Green has again rattled the world champion. With every punch, he edges a step closer.
I'd love to know what Stipe Drews is saying up there.
I wonder if Danny even understands what he's saying.
I'm sure he doesn't, unless he's learned Croatian and he's training as well, which I don't think he would have bothered.
He said it in English. He said, don't punch when holding.
Somebody said, don't punch when holding.
Again, Drews gets out of the way and does so very nicely. 70 seconds remain, round number 6. We're going to be halfway home at the end of this minute.
It's a controlled performance from Danny Green. You couldn't ask anything more at this stage of the fight.
No, he's cutting him off well. He's calm.
He's sticking with what's working.
Left hook now as he's going to the side.
Stipe Drews trying to frustrate Danny Green.
Referee warning him to fight.
Yeah, fair enough.
You've got gloves on, Stipe. It's time to use them.
Well, he's not going to win the fight running. I don't have to explain to you why Stipe Drews is on the back foot.
Oh. Nice jab from Stipe Drews.
Oh, left hand.
20 seconds left, round number 6. Drews a warning for inactivity midway through the round.
Lovely jab.
Strong, straight punches from Danny Green are doing the damage here. Stipe Drews hasn't got an answer.
No.
Green stalking, edging his way across the ring. Short, sharp shuffles. Bell sounds. We're halfway home. And unofficially, Stipe Drews has not won a round.
No, I don't see how he could have won a round.
Was there an even round, maybe?
No.
I can't even see an even round.
No, I don't think it was. He landed, the first time he's landed a couple of shots, and Danny landed a couple of beautiful stiff lefts and put the pressure on him, had him running, actually. I don't know how Drews intends to retain his world championship unless he does a hell of a lot more in the second half of the fight.
Does he still think Danny Green's going to run out of gas?
Well, I'll tell you,
is that the plan?
He could fight 20 rounds.
What a left hand.
Danny Green's been training with the boys from the Parramatta Rugby League Football Club, Hayden Knowles, Craig Catterick, under the eye of Dr. Steve McNamara and Kevin Ivans. This World Championship Showcase beginning live from the Challenge Stadium in Western Australia. Danny Green looking to join world boxing's most elite club.
Stipe Drews can wait all night. Danny Green's not going to be worried about that.
All he's doing is feeling with that hand, that right hand. It's not even a jab.
Green doubling up with the left hand. Neither found the mark, but Drews again on the back foot.
If you think back to the Bayer fights and Anthony Mundine, they didn't beat Danny Green by running on the outside. I think this is a different Danny Green. This is a more forceful, stronger, healthier Danny Green.
Definitely a lot healthier and stronger. Putting on scientific pressure.
Here you go. Oh, Green gets caught between the ropes, smiles. Drews had a shot there, didn't take it.
Well, you know, Danny was up to it. He bobbed and weaved. He would have made anything miss. He did that well.
Just shows you how switched on he was. The awareness was there.
The awareness is certainly there.
Once again, Drews just waiting.
Exactly. He's been waiting every round.
And he's giving Danny Green a chance to have a little break.
I'd never be critical of a world champion, any boxer for that matter of fact, but a very soft title defence from Stipe Drews, if this indeed is how he will continue. Just not throwing the volume of punches required.
Good exchange of blows by both fighters there.
It was some better work from Drews.
It was. Maybe his best shots of the fight so far. Is he winning the round, though?
I don't believe so. With a minute remaining, this is round seven.
Up for grabs this round, still.
Danny Green taking the fight to Stipe Drews, who moves back into a southpaw. His more traditional and comfortable stance. All the sparring for Danny Green with Alexander Gurov and also Colin Wilson. Big southpaws. It's paying off.
Referee giving the fighters a little wave there to actually trade punches.
He's getting a bit frustrated, the ref. The ref's doing a very good job.
I like this referee.
Yeah, he's a good, very, very good referee.
Drews is in an unusual position. He's only lost once before in his career. How is he feeling right now?
Green over the top of the right shoulder with the left hand. Final couple of seconds of round number seven. Another Danny Green round. And there's the left hand of Green.
You know,
what on earth is Stipe Drews trying to achieve?
That was Stipe Drews' best round, and I still couldn't give it to him.
No. Let's have a look at some of the action from round seven. That was Danny getting tangled up, a little smile on the face at the end.
Drews running around the ring, using the ring, doing nothing.
A very controlled performance from Danny Green so far. Very impressive.
Most pundits at ringside are still trying to figure out the game plan of the Croatian.
Maybe he thinks it's 15, Barry.
I don't think so, Paul. No, I just don't think he can handle the strength and pressure of Danny Green, and has really got no counter at this stage. Maybe, as you said, hoping they were going to run out of gas, but I don't think that's going to be an option somehow.
Two scoring punches for Danny Green as he moved into the world champion. Is Green the world champion in waiting?
Green just looks so much stronger. He's a much better light heavyweight, I think there's no doubt about that.
Yeah. 40 seconds into round number 8, and Green trying to corner the Spider-Man.
Okay. Referee is all over Drews again.
The holding from Drews, not from Green. Danny's trying to punch in there, and Drews grabs him as soon as he gets up close. Good stiff scoring jab in the midsection. Drews using the ring, running around the ring. The crowd are giving him some.
But even when he makes Danny Green miss, he's not countering either, Barry.
No.
What is the plan?
I'm still scratching my head, trying to figure it out, Paul. Danny Green has almost stood in the centre of the ring, chasing Stipe Drews.
I think the case is he doesn't have a plan. Danny Green is fighting a very controlled fight. He's putting pressure on, he's punching with authority, and Drews doesn't know how to handle it.
Let me tell you, the referee's getting frustrated. He wants Drews to have a go and to fight. Look at Danny just having it. Looks like he's having a good time up there.
Now is not the time to have a good time with a minute 10 remaining, round 8.
Danny is controlling the pace of the fight. He's working when he wants to work, and he's having a little rest when he wants to rest.
Look, he's trying to feint Drews, and he gets, and he lands. He lands with a clean shot. Drews has got no answer to it.
Barry, we've seen Stipe Drews take several Danny Green shots. Sure, he hasn't hit him with the big one, but it appears unlikely, I think, that Danny will stop him.
Yeah, I think maybe Paul got it right at the start. I mean, it looks at this stage, you know, Danny gets on him and corners him and lands a succession of blows, he can put him away, but the guy's got a good chin, he's been hit with some good shots.
With the
and the way he's fighting, Danny's going to find it hard to pull him up, isn't he?
Well, with a fight like this, why would he change his tactics?
Yeah.
Danny Green's clearly winning. There's no need to take any risks at this stage.
Yep.
Just keep doing what he's doing.
That was a better combination from Drews.
Two of the best Drews punches we've seen for rounds.
The best in the whole fight, I think. Good jab back there.
There's the receipt from Danny Green.
Danny Green's in control. He doesn't need to risk anything.
Danny Green's a fighter. He loves it.
Danny Green is winning this fight so easily we didn't believe it would happen.
This is round 9.
There is absolutely no emotion, no instruction, nothing coming from the red corner during the break. Stipe Drews went over and sat on his stool and was basically ignored.
Okay, I think the boys in the corner must realise that they're facing an uphill battle. So far, he hasn't put a dent in Danny Green's armour at all. And Danny Green has put a few dents in his, even though he's been on the back foot the whole fight.
Is it a case of Drews not wanting to be knocked out and just lose on points?
Don't know, that was a good right hand from Drews. That was probably the best shot he's thrown. Didn't look like it hurt Danny one bit, though. He's trying to load that left hand up, Drews.
I'm trying to be positive, Barry, and think that maybe Stipe thinks that he can finish Danny late. I don't see it happening.
Well, if he thinks that, he's got to land punches.
I think you need a tank to stop Danny Green tonight.
Yep, fair call.
Green focusing his attention on the torso of the world champion, Stipe Drews. Born in Croatia, based out of Germany.
Drews seems reluctant to take any risks, like he doesn't want to be knocked out, he just wants to lose on points.
He's tentative, he's very tentative.
Oh, Green! A big right hand from Danny Green.
Holding.
Jolted the head back.
Referee will take points off here shortly.
I don't speak Croatian, but whenever he gets hurt, he's got a big smile on his face, and there's been a lot of smiling.
If they take any points off Stipe Drews, he'll finish in the negatives.
He will. The crowd going berserk here. As Stipe Drews continues to circle the ring, use the perimeter of the ring just to stay away from the power of Danny Green. He's in an orthodox stance now, Stipe Drews.
A thorough, a complete performance thus far from Danny Green.
This is amazing me. I mean, Stipe Drews is the world champion. He's not throwing punches.
Maybe we're underselling Danny Green. Maybe he just shows what a great fighter he is. Stipe Drews may be WBA world champion at the moment, but Danny Green is putting on a world-class performance tonight.
Yeah, he's boxing very well, very controlled boxing.
And just because Danny Green lost to Anthony Mundine doesn't mean he's a bad fighter.
Oh, God, no.
A lot of people wrote Danny Green off after that loss to Mundine.
Nice left hand from Danny Green. Certainly not the case.
I think it just shows you what a classy fighter Mundine is.
Oh, you know, this goes without saying.
Some blood on the left temple of Danny Green. Is it his cut? Is it Drews? Is it the nose of Drews? I don't believe it is.
I don't know, but it's another Danny Green round. I know why you do take
risk. You hit this. Round number 9 followed a very similar path to those rounds before, Barry. It was Danny Green center ring following Stipe Drews around.
But Stipe Drews still doing nothing, or next to nothing. Round 10.
Nine minutes remain. Can Danny Green complete the fairy tale with a knockout? As long as the hand is raised in victory, it really doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Method of victory. It'd be nice, though.
It would be nice, but Drews, they call him Spider-Man. I can understand why now. He's certainly hard to catch cleanly. Danny's caught him on a number of occasions, but when he lands one or two, Drews grabs and holds.
Neither guy is marked up, really,
no.
Facially. Okay. Box on, says our referee, Takeshi Shimakawa, who has done a good job in the difficult circumstances at times at early rounds.
Done a very good job, the ref, but every time Danny Green gets up on him and tries to unload, Drews grabs hold of him. And the rest of the round, he's just using the ring, trying to stay away. I'd like to see Danny throw a few of those left hooks. He caught him with a ripper earlier. Drews has tasted the power and he's not keen to get involved.
There's a few boos from the crowd. Drews is just on this bike. He doesn't want to engage. He's not playing, no offense at all. How is he going to win this fight from here?
Danny Green taking out a bit of frustration there.
Another smile from the Croatian.
Another smile from Drews. No smile from Danny Green.
Danny Green just doing the job he had to do. They tried the left hook there. Drews is backing away.
Coming in tonight, Drews had won 32 fights in his career. And the way he's fighting at the moment, it makes you wonder the quality of opponents he really fought.
Oh, that's the best left hand Drews has thrown the whole fight.
But doesn't follow it up, Barry.
No, one punch.
Goes back into reverse. The crowd want to see Danny Green win. But the crowd want to see Danny Green put Stipe Drews on his backside now. They are as frustrated as no doubt you are watching around Australia.
You have to say this is a one-sided fight and the crowd want to see a knockout.
They always do want to see a knockout, especially from the hometown boy. But Drews is trying not to get involved. Oh, he's going to get warm for...
Two overhand right hands from Danny Green.
The referee shakes his head, but I guess he also feels that lost the mouth guard, Drews, I think. Ed. Another 10-9 round pull.
100 to 90 is how I have it at the moment. That is unofficially.
Seconds down, round 11.
An ultimate round coming your way as we have a look at some of the action from the 10th. This is round 11. Stipe Drews, 6 minutes away from handing the gold belt to Australian Danny Green. Will it finish before then?
I think it's going the distance, Andy.
Yeah,
Drews is not going to engage. He doesn't want to be knocked out.
You're right. He doesn't want to be. He doesn't want to engage. He stands toe to toe with Danny. Will get knocked out.
Let's see where Stipe Drews goes from here.
Hey, boss.
A couple of good shots as Danny Green moved in close to him then. But again, back onto that left foot, back into retreat mode.
And then he'll land a shot and he'll grab. Very awkward guy to fight. Very, very awkward. Good right hand from Green.
The
only way they're going to touch gloves is Takeshi Shimaya actually extending the gloves for them. Bit of feeling in this one. Our referee Shimakawa, by and large, a fabulous job. He stayed well and truly out of this.
That was a perfect example. Drews made Danny Green miss, but he did nothing, counter.
Didn't counter. Danny tried a big left hook.
Drews waiting. What's he waiting for?
He's been waiting all night.
Green over the top of that right shoulder with a left hand. Caught the attention of Drews, didn't have the power to hurt him. You can understand Drews being so tentative if he had two completely swollen shut eyes, a broken nose, and was going to require 50 stitches.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like he's been touched, Barry.
Well, he has been, but not a great deal. He just hasn't wanted to get involved. I mean, how can you win a fight like this?
Maybe there's an injury we're not aware of.
No, I don't know. No.
He's moving all right.
Yeah, no, he's moving well.
I'm just trying to find an explanation because I don't believe what I'm seeing in a world title fight. I'm sorry.
It's all one-way traffic.
One-way traffic, anticlimactic, certainly disappointing, but the end result is Australia is going to have a new world champion.
He just tried an uppercut there, Drew, something he hasn't done the whole fight. 20-something seconds remaining in the 11th round. Coming up the 22nd.
It is all Danny Green.
I mark this round even before the finish.
Dangerous move from Barry Michael.
Dangerous move, yeah, maybe.
Oh, the two come together.
Danny indicating a little bit of head clashing.
More of the same. Centre ring. That's the face of defeat. You just saw it from Stipe Drews. A forlorn figure slouched over his stool as the boys come out for just 3 more minutes.
A nice embrace there from both fighters.
A certain respect between the two.
The crowd sensing the victory.
The clock is ticking down from 3 minutes.
Danny's not going to take any risks in this round at all.
Heard him say during the break, I'm the world champion. I'm not going to do anything stupid.
Look, he's just jabbing. He's shadow boxing.
Got to be very cautious. It's Danny Green here. Back in the opening 40 seconds, Stipe Drews has probably thrown more punches here than he has in any other period of the fight.
He has, because that's because Danny's decided that he's just going to have a rest because he's won every round.
So, Barry, you don't think we'll see a split decision, do we?
I don't think so.
I'll be surprised if Drews wins a round.
Well, we haven't given him a round.
Under 2 minutes remaining. And this Western Australian fan base, all 5,500 of them here at the Challenge Stadium, are counting down the seconds.
You know, I think this is the most aggressive Drews has been in the whole fight.
He's still moving backwards, eh, Barry?
Yeah, he is now that Danny's put a bit of pressure on him. Danny Green took a bit of a rest there for a minute or so, I think.
90 seconds and counting. You can hear the crowd, you can feel the crowd. Danny Green is enjoying the crowd.
It'd be nice to see Danny Green come home with a couple of bombs. We know he's won the title, but it would be nice to see him finish. I mean, he knows he's won it by a mile.
By the proverbial country mile, too.
And every second will feel like a minute to Danny Green right now.
Oh, for sure. We're under a minute remaining.
This has been Danny Green's easiest fight in quite some time.
I'll say now, this is Danny Green's best ever career performance.
He fought beautifully. This is Stipe Drews' best round of the whole fight.
Drews is a very good fighter, and Danny Green's made him look ordinary tonight.
Yeah.
30 seconds to go. The kid from Scarborough, Western Australia, is on the verge of pinning his name in the boxing history books.
Great performance from Danny Green tonight.
Represented Australia at the 98 Commonwealth Games. He was a 2000 Olympian, and on this day, the 16th of December, 2007, Danny Green is your new world champion.
Without doubt.
The judges' decisions are in. And the scorecards read as follows. Judge Legland from France has scored the bout 118-111. Judge Miller from the United States has scored the bout 118-110. Judge Martinez from the United States has scored the bout 120-108. The winner by unanimous points decision and the new WBA light heavyweight champion of the world, Danny Green Machine Green.
Danny Green is the champion of the world. A case perhaps of third time lucky after the disappointments of Germany in August 03 and March 05. After the disappointment of Anthony Mundine at the Sydney Football Stadium in May 06, he has climbed the mountain. Very gently around the waist. It will not leave that waist all night long. Get a word with Danny Green in a second. He's soaking it all up. Being cheered around the ring. And not one of the 5,500 in attendance have left.
Danny, congratulations. History tonight. You're the world champion. You've done it in front of your friends, your family and your fans. What a night.
I've got no voice left. Firstly, I promised with Green Machine Promotions, and I promised a long time ago that just before you go crazy, guys, I want to have a little chat. As you know, I can talk like a chair. We promised we'd bring the world title to Perth. I promised I'd bring it down under. I promised I'd win it. I've been an interim world champion. You can shove that up your ass. shove it right up your ass! I'm the official world champion, not Ingram, not Park Lawn, not whatever. I'm just so happy, and I'm just so proud. My wife, Nina, I love you so much, sweetheart. You hang on to my little boy or girl in the belly bubbles. I love you. Chloe Green, this one's for you, love. It's for you, darling, and for Western Australia and for Australia. Thank you so much. I've been through incredible highs. I've been through incredible lows. I've been robbed in Germany, and I've been absolutely distraught over losing big fights. And now my backyard, it doesn't get any better than this apart from when my new baby comes tonight, tomorrow, the next day. Thank you to Jack McGlynn and AIW Holdings for supporting the event. Aaron Hankplug, my first ever sponsor. Brian Craig from Fixcon. Billy Mead from Guardian Solution. Big bustling Steve Bowden. From, used to be the Rich Hurstville, he's given up his Hawaiian holiday in Mexico. Love you, Fabiano. Also, Frank from Wareside. Who else is there? Paul O'Neill from Boost Mobile. Thanks, Pon. Whoever else I've forgotten that sponsored me and looked after me, I can't thank you guys enough. It means so much to me, especially to my family who've been through a tough 1.5 years. This just brings a ray of sunshine. I'm so proud to do it. And love you, BG, Jules, Bumalewi, my whole family, all the boys, my H-man, he's been there from the beginning. Thanks, mate. I'd also like to thank Jeff Fennec, who doesn't speak to me anymore, but I wouldn't be here if I hadn't taken up boxing with him in the first place. Thank you, Jeff, for all the help and support and the good times we had together. Wizard, Brooker, Noel Patterson, Dave Birchall, Ray Birchall, Pat De Valera is my first ever coach, Salas, Ismael Salas, Amen! Billy Bob Mead, all the guys, look, I'm sorry.
Mate, you're right over the moon. I've got to ask you the question, though. These fans love you. They're so happy that you're now the world champ. There's a rematch on the horizon, though, and they want to see it in Perth.
I'm the official world champion. He's an interim champion. It's in my backyard, and it's on my terms for now. We're talking turkey. Also, Justin Manolakis, Mick Pemba, Pauline Wilson, Rob Brady, and also Wayne Loxley from Green Machine Promotions. Guys, this doesn't happen without that five guys. Jack Cowan from Hungry Jacks, thanks very much as well for supporting me all my career, mate. Guys, what can I say? I love everyone in here. I'm stoked.
Woo! Danny Green!
They are still standing. They are still cheering because they have a new world champion as True Blue echoes around the auditorium. What a night in Australian sports.
That explains Danny Green through and through, True Blue, that's for sure. He did Australia proud when he didn't win a round, Stipe Drews. The last judge got it right.
It was the most impressive performance I've seen from Danny Green in his career. He just totally bamboozled Stipe Drews tonight. Drews had no answer. We're talking about a world champion, a world-class fighter, and Danny Green just showed his best tonight.
Yes, he boxed beautifully.
He's a better boxer than he is singer, Danny Green. What a night. Let's take a look at the results. Adam Wills defeated Robert Sanders, split points decision. Then it was Peter Cronier over former national heavyweight champion Colin Wilson. Jackson Asiku, too good for the unpredictable Matthew Powell tonight. Stephen Wills, Thomas Yakubu, a draw. Our semi-main event was William Pickett, Tommy Brown. It was the unanimous points decision. And our main event, Australia has a new world champion. He is the WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. He is Danny Green.